Hello, Selena, or Selena, I'm sorry if I've mispronounced your name. I also apologize for misspelling it there the other day. So I'm creating some video, give you some feedback on your five characteristics images. So we'll sort of get the screen share going here. Move me into position here. So, all right, let's take a look. Direction. So first thing I'm noticing, of course, is these are all, you know, identical compositions. And the idea of each of these assignments, even though we're doing multiple images within a particular module, you want to vary those compositions. And I know you did vary those compositions quite a bit. But then when you go back and you're looking at your images and selecting which ones to post, be sure that you take care in making sure those images all look individually composed. The repetition here is you know, identical. In fact, I'm not really seeing evidence that the light is moving around here, and that's a problem. I want to be sure that you are clearly understanding what the component of direction is, so that you're not confused about that. Direction is of the five components of light that we're working with. Direction is the first and the most fundamental. So we may need to have a one-on-one conversation about direction if these images are representative of your understanding. It's missing a little bit, because as you can see, there is no sense of where the light is coming from here. In fact, this image and this image look quite identical. And so we want to correct that. I want to be sure that you have a full understanding of the concept of direction. Looks like that's the only one that you are having trouble with. The others look like you're moving forward, although we do have a color image here that is included in your intensity. So let's continue to explore your posting. Intensity, that's going to be all about two lights and the relationship of those two lights. One is the key light, which is very bright. The other is the fill light, which is supplementing the shadows, kind of filling in the shadows, if you were. Some decent work here. You know, we don't have super heavy shadows going on. Again, I had mentioned we have a color image here, which shouldn't be. This comes back to project specifications. The outline of the project is meant to offer you a form and a framework from which to work. And when we're working in the industry, when we're working as professionals, project specifications are very important. You're not going to be any wiggle room at all on whether the project can be this way or that way. And so in this case, you know, they needed to be black and white other than the temperature ones. And so you'll want to take care to follow those instructions to the letter. Let's take a look at your temperature here. And some nice subtle variations here, as we're seeing. In some cases, it gets a little warm, and then I asked you guys to push the extremes on there. This one gets a bit to be a little orange. Again, we have compositional repetition here. This one and this one are identical, and they don't really belong in the same posting. So as you move forward, be sure that as you're selecting compositions to post, that there's variation in those compositions. We don't necessarily want to see the same composition over and over again, unless it is specified in the instructions that it's the same composition. So there will be some experiments in which the composition doesn't change. In this case, in these compositions, they didn't. Every composition should look different. That'll be something you're going to want to go back into. Contrast. Now, contrast is really primarily about the shades, the variations of gray in between the image. You got your light, and you got your dark, and then all of the shades in between establish contrast. So just white and just black would be the highest contrast. We manipulate that using the reflectors, the white reflectors in your image, so that we can create variations between those using a hard light, a light that doesn't have anything in front of it. So let's take a look and see what we have here. It's very nice shadow work. This is beautiful. This is a beautiful use of shadow, quite lovely. We could have cropped in just a little bit more. You may, it very well might not have even seen this in your viewfinder, but this edge right here isn't really contributing to the composition. This is your hero right here, this shape in here that's created. Quite lovely, quite beautiful, nicely done. Now you have that broken up a little bit here. This is still quite good. The repetition of the shadow, the repetition of the highlights. Again, we're a little bit tense on this edge here. We don't need the edge of that bottle there. You won't be able to see my hand, but if I could put my hand up there and cover this up, kind of where this mouse is going right here, would have improved the composition quite a bit. But beautiful work with the lighting here. Very good. Nice and subtle, that's quite interesting. And simplicity can really work. We lost focus just a little bit here. This is not out of focus enough. And that's a tough thing to discover, and you will after making photograph after photograph. How out of focus does something need to be in order for us to accept it as out of focus or missed focus? There's a big difference between out of focus and missed focus. And this is enough in focus to make it look like, I'm not sure if she meant for it to be in or out of focus. So, you know, that's again, something that you will pick up on through experience in shooting. Hardness, that's all about the shadows, how crisp or how not crisp the shadows are. We achieve that by diffusing the light, by putting diffusers over the light. And in some cases in this project, you were asked to diffuse one light, not the other, then diffuse the other light, and then diffuse both lights. And we should see examples of all of that in your posting here. Let's see, hardness. This one of your lights is definitely not diffused, I can tell, because of the hardness of the shadows. Undiffused light, light that doesn't have anything in front of it, is going to create a sharp line. Here you can see the difference. This is a diffused light. I can tell because look how soft those lights, the shadows are. The edges are sort of feathered out. That immediately reveals to me as a photographer at how you did it. And when you're looking at photography, you can really start to break it down that way. You can look at imagery and say, I know how they lit that. And it's kind of cool. Looks like you did a decent job. I mean, I'd like to see more variation, but it looks okay. Let's see what your peers are saying here. Overall, good focus, light and shadow, compositions, temperature, and good variety in display. You notice you have a strong sense of temperature and hardness. I'm not sure what that means, a strong sense of temperature and hardness. There's a good use of shadow contrast. I would say that is true. A lot of repetition to take away from the objective or the message of that, yes. Your compositions are very repetitive. We've talked about that, so we definitely want to look back on that. Your direction needs work. We need to have you go back and reinvestigate your direction, because from what you've posted, doesn't look like you are expressing your full understanding of that concept. And so I need you to reevaluate that and see what we can do to get you on the right page there. You probably have a better understanding of direction than what you're posting here, but we want your posting to reflect your true understanding. Let's see what else we have here as far as, forgot to include your name on the title. Oh yes, that's a very good point. Definitely include your name, every single posting, your name, underscore, whatever it is. So be sure you do that. That's a very good point. Seventh image does a wonderful display of composition and light and direction. First few photos in the same section appear to be diffused light instead of light direction. That's a good observation. Yes, very good, very good. temperature images, include intensity section. Yeah, you got some things mixed up a little bit, and that, you know, some of it might in fact have a little bit to do with how you posted it, you know, and again, we can discuss that, you know, on a one-on-one at some point. So you'll receive also, you'll receive a numeric grade from me, but I thought these videos would be helpful just in terms of getting some feedback on your imagery. All right, we'll see you in class.